Welcome everyone to another episode of Replay. We're glad to have you here. I'm Andrew Reiner. Today we're taking a look at Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone for you in America. Scratch out sorcerers if you're in the UK. That is Philosopher's Stone. It had two names. Kyle Hilliard's here.
Alert. Way better. As Philosopher's Stone is much better.
We have Ben Hanson here, big Harry Potter fan as well.
Harry Potterhead and the sorcerers who got stoned, guys.
And then Tim Turi, somehow, who consumes a lot of media and fantasy and crazy
Souls.
Stuff, knows nothing about Harry Potter.
But that. There are a lot of... This game came out, then there's a lot of books and movies, right?
Based that's right. Based on this game.
Okay. Yep, that's right. That's not correct.
That's so cool.
There was many versions of this made. There's like four different developers that worked on Sorcerer's Stone games at the same time.
Okay.
Argonaut, who made this one, it's just on PS1. That's what you're looking at here. This is a game a lot of people didn't see because PS2 was in its prime at this point.
I would disagree with that, Reiner. This is one of the top-selling games on PlayStation 1.
Yeah, I think this is the one.
This is like in the top four PlayStation 1 games of all time.
Is it really?
Hey, Wade, can you fix my comment and make it sound intelligent and correct?
This is a game a lot of people didn't see because PS2 was in the prime at this point.
Thank you.
Motorcycles?
Yeah.
Why are there motorcycles?
Wait. Tim, how much do you know? Like, what's your baseline here?
Whatever just surfaces to the top. Something about... abracadabra,
kid,
Hogwarts.
You're getting the full story right here, and you're just glossing over it.
Do you know the word Voldemort? Does that mean anything to
yes,
you?
Yes, bad guy.
I don't know.
Snape.
I don't know.
Snape was Alan Rickman, rest in peace.
Yep.
You're a wizard, Harry. he lived under stairs.
Okay, that's pretty. Yeah.
What happens to Dumbledore?
Oh, don't tell him.
Dumbledore is Ian McKellen, right?
Close enough.
Yeah.
So is this based on the book?
Movie? So it's kind of like that.
The Lord of the Rings, Fellowship of the Rings game.
The Hobbit.
Yeah.
I mean, the film.
Both of them are like
pretty damn close to the book, though. I mean, they're not that separate, you know. I
guess. So you played this, Kyle?
Oh yeah, I played and beat this when it came out.
Is it good?
No.
Why was your guy riding a motorbike?
Because that's Sirius Black's motorcycle that he just got.
There's motorcycles.
Right. Tim, this takes place in modern England.
That's
in the 90s.
Look, I think it's 99.
This is based on the movie. That is totally her from the movie.
That does look like
Wendy
her.
Wendy Moyer, Angela Darling?
Yes.
Harry Potter takes place in the 90s?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
No, there's a lot of like talk to the hand references.
Well, actually, there's no cell phones. Muggles don't have cell phones in Harry Potter or anything like that. I'm a big Harry Potter fan. I don't know if you guys know this about me.
Okay, so motor, like steam, like gasoline technology. Like
yeah, we
that.
Had gasoline that's, in the 90s.
It's an enchanted motorcycle, basically.
It really takes place in the 90s.
Yes,
it super takes place in the 90s.
Yes.
That's insane. That's insane.
Tim, like it gets crazier.
Oh, God,
like.
Dumbledore looks awful.
Oh,
Harry looks
boy.
Okay.
Harry Potter takes place in the 90s in our world?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, like there's like Dementors and shit like flying around London. It's cool.
Yeah, there's a scene where like
there are cell phones?
They interact with like the London government at a certain point.
That's insane.
They're like, hey, by the way, shit's going down in the wizarding world. Just want to give you guys a heads
Tim.
Up.
No. Hogwarts. Oh no, we do have spoken dialogue.
Harry. Yeah. So search behind
every door. I had no idea.
Tim, your mind's getting blown.
I thought they were just trying to make their own
but there's
fantasy
no,
world.
But what's confusing is there's no electricity at Hogwarts. They have like a radio, and that's as high tech as they get.
So they're like
pretty much
the village. Like
ooh,
the village. From
it's
the
exactly
village.
Like the village.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay,
no reds allowed.
There's no jump button.
No jump
I'm
buttons
put,
are allowed.
Put that out. This button just makes the camera go wonky.
Oh, that's the trigger. You're pulling triggers there.
Those hourglasses?
It looks.
Those are the house point cups.
Why are
no,
they
are
not?
You a wizard?
That needs to be put back
you're
up
a wizard,
there,
Harry.
Man.
Nitwit,
blubber, don't look at my face, Harry.
What? Are his eyebrows urinating? What's happening?
That's a wizard thing, man. I don't know about that.
Wonderful place. Huggy Wardy. Tom Bombadil? Like, what's.
He kind of is, actually.
Why is he rhyming?
Yeah.
There is a Tom Riddle who's very Tom Bombadil.
Okay.
Well, he just doesn't act like
okay,
Tom Bombadil.
Let's talk about the dumbest moment in all of Harry Potter.
Right,
I have several because...
Oh, the final book. The final book has the dumbest moment.
What? I want to get into
Stephen
all this
Stephen King
stuff.
Went into this. He called it Harry Potter and the Half-Assed Plan.
Okay, all right, that's fair.
Well, go ahead.
He's a
you
kid.
Go first, Hanson.
Okay, so...
Okay, there's one room
there's
I can
a
go
A lot
through.
Of dumb things in this whole series. So I was 100% in Tim's camp
Wait,
until,
two.
Like...
I gotta explore the doors.
Until about a month ago. I was sick of like having this blind spot in nerddom. So many people make references to Dementors and Death Eaters. I'm like, I just want to figure out what all this stuff is. So I went on a marathon.
That's where I am too.
Okay, you should watch all those movies. The movies are about a 7 out of 10. Like almost
really? Like all together, you think?
If I had to average all of them out, yeah, there's definitely highs and lows in there, but they're not amazing. Oh my.
Don't look them in the lips. Whatever you do, don't look them in the lips.
Portraits have moving people in them in Harry Potter world.
Anybody catch what he wanted?
A password.
He was just saying hi.
Guess the password.
Yeah, you got to get the password to get into your house.
Shut down the game.
Kyle, you
Harry.
Played this. What the hell am I doing? Ugh,
it's been a while.
So wait, should do you not feel rewarded in having taken the dive, Ben?
I do. Yeah, I forgot a surprising amount. I drank a lot of wine throughout all these films, but it's nice to have that plugged. But the problem is, like, there's still thousands of pages, and there's so many things in the movies that don't make sense, and you have to consult Harry Potter experts. It's like, oh, in the book, that makes sense why he has that shard of that mirror that just randomly appears in the fifth or sixth film.
It's because there is a huge crossover. The books are, like, as successful as the movies, right? Like,
how so?
Well, they're the Weasley twins.
Like, the books are insanely successful, right? And so are the movies. So it seems like there's a good chance that most people have read the books and seen the movies.
But I would recommend watching the movies. Just, I mean, for like the John Williams score alone, John Williams score, and especially in the second film, they go hard on practical effects.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Cool. They're fun.
Yeah, they're all fine.
It's worth it.
Is that his gallbladder?
Is that the shape?
I think so, yeah.
Is he in flashbacks?
How would you know about that?
What type of game is this?
It's like an adventure game. You kind of like solve puzzles mostly. Sometimes you chase birds outside in a sequence that was really frustrating.
As PlayStation 1 games go, we were making fun of it. It looks pretty good for what it is. The camera is surprisingly not making me sick. The textures aren't tearing all over the place like they do. Like, this looks like a late PlayStation 1 game. Like,
right.
I think it was your owl Hedwig.
His Hedwig. Head.
Wig.
Okay. So my worst moment?
Oh, hang on. I didn't explain mine yet.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
The dumbest moment. I have several of them, but right, the number one dumbest moment.
Is this a spoiler?
I think so. You just want to talk to people. Oh, you got to find Hedwig.
Sam, I'm going
to
spoil it. It's a tiny thing early on. I think it's in the second film, and I'm curious how they addressed it in the books. But Tom Riddle, there's this kid who used to go to Hogwarts. His name is Tom Riddle. They lay out his entire name, and they have, like, the letters are, like, floating in the air, and then he rearranges it, and it rearranges to say, I am Lord Voldemort. Which implies that Tom Riddle chose the name Voldemort as an anagram of his name, but not directly. It's an anagram for I am Lord Voldemort, so he planned the name Voldemort with the condition that at some point he was going to reveal that to somebody and explain, I am Lord Voldemort.
Yep, man. Evil people, they are weird, and they have, like, agendas that we just can't understand.
Why did he put his dumb horcruxes in these super obvious objects? Like, put it in a mailbox and bury it in a desert.
That's how horcruxes work. They have to be these, like, emotional objects that...
That was never explained.
Okay.
Okay, I did not know that.
Yeah, they can't just be anything. You can't just be like, all right, this fucking magazine's going to be part
of
my soul.
Wait, so Voldemort was hiding in plain sight is basically the story.
Well, it's like, they're like, oh man, he split his soul, so to kill him, we have to take out these six, eight? How many Horcruxes are there?
Oh, it's seven. That's the plot to Castlevania 2.
Okay, exactly.
You have to take the pieces of Dracula, put them back together so you can kill
him. But imagine if Dracula's like, they'll never find me. How about I hide my souls in these cups of blood hidden around a house. Like, it's so obvious where all of these things are. So it's just like a puzzle then to go find them all. But Reiner, what is your dumbest moment?
Well, real quick, Ben, Reddit has given us a great list of all the other anagrams that can be made from Tom Marvolo Riddle.
What else we got?
We got Motor Marvel Dildo.
That would really be He Who Must Not Be Named. Because they would just feel embarrassed to
say
his
name. In the 90s, there were Motor Marvel Dildos as well.
There are a lot, but also there's Immortal Love Rod.
That's good, too.
Just a lot of good ones.
All right, Reiner, I still want to hear your dumbest moment.
Okay, yeah, so
that I can knock it down.
Here's a minor spoiler. Harry Potter is not dead by the final book.
Right.
It is still called Harry Potter.
They did announce a new book coming out.
Seems like he's dead inside with that marriage, though. But
A huge spoiler. But anyway, so the bad guys want Harry dead.
Poor Tim is like, what's happening?
The bad guys want Harry dead, and they've wanted this for a while, right?
Uh-huh.
Hey, I got a chocolate frog, man.
Burp?
Yeah.
Did you burp or the frog?
Yeah, I burp because I ate a chocolate frog.
Oh, all right.
That's the thing.
They're sentient beings that you shove in your mouth and digest.
Anyway, so they want Harry dead. So the good guys decide, we got to protect Harry.
Mm-hmm.
What's the best way to protect Harry?
Make a bunch of Harrys?
Put him in a mailbox, bury him in the desert.
Everyone make look like Harry Potter. So these bad guys are probably killing Harrys left and right. Like, why not turn Harry into someone else?
That's a much better idea.
Because I can see through that.
I think that's what it was. I think they could see through that or something like
also,
that.
Also, there's a lot of...
But then why turn the other people into Harry? Because they could see through that too.
Because they're willing. They were willing to sacrifice themselves in order to protect Harry.
Tim, don't look at these snails and ghosts. We're trying to talk about how stupid Harry Potter is.
That's nearly headless Nick.
What are those dumb snails?
I know Ron vomits them up at one point because he hits himself with his own broken wand.
Ron Vomidale?
Yeah.
So he vomits snails and now these enemies?
Do
the
I do something
yeah,
cause, with these?
Yeah, because the bad guy basically called his friend Hermione like an offensive term and Ron got really upset. Mudblood. I don't want to say it because it's a
bad word.
It's inappropriate, Hanson. I'm just kidding.
College book two.
Yeah. And
Mudblood.
Yeah, and he tried to, you know, attack somebody, but his wand's all messed up, so he hit himself. Ooh. And he was throwing those up for hours.
Nice.
Yeah.
Did he say anything while he did it?
Yeah, he could talk.
It's weird. It's kinda like he's green and like little bully, he's kinda just like hungover, it's kinda like the overall tone. L2 and R2 buttons. All right, I love this. That's a big part of the films. The L2 button.
Alex, really good.
Hey, you know what else?
Who is that guy? I'm a big Harry Potter guy. I have no idea what that character is.
You know what else was a really dumb thing?
It was Chancellor Palpatine.
Yeah. <he's> There he is.
Remember in like the sixth film?
Okay, that's...
When they were trying...
That's Half-Blood Prince, I guess?
Yeah, Harry and Dumbledore were going on a little mission.
Yeah.
I think they were trying to get the Horcrux, and it was hidden at the bottom, basically like a giant bird bath is the way I remember this.
Zombies.
And then Dumbledore says, the only way... to get to that item is I've got to drink all of this water.
That's the spell.
It's never explained.
You can't empty it.
So then it becomes like a man versus food segment where Dumbledore's like, I can't drink anymore. I can't do it. It's the dumbest
fucking
sequence.
Wait, why? It's enchanted, so he can't empty it. It doesn't work that way. It's the only way to take it. You have to injure yourself in order to ingest
it.
Okay,
maybe in the books and in the movies, it's I got
to
drink all this stuff.
Maybe you should just be more open-minded is all I'm saying.
It's dumb. It is a dumb thing.
Just a quick fact check from the Harry Potter wiki.
Good lord.
Thank you, Wade.
The Emerald Potion, also known as the Drink of Despair, is a mysterious potion in which it induces fear, delirium, and extreme thirst. According to Dumbledore, the potion cannot be penetrated by hand, vanished, parted, scooped away, siphoned away, transfigured, charmed, or otherwise made to change its nature in any other way.
Okay, look, that's all well and good.
Does that change your opinion?
No! It's not. The film is still stupid with the way it presents that dumb chug-a-lug challenge.
Oh, the chug-a-lug. That's what Voldemort called it, actually.
And it was, where all of his students just chanting, chug, chug, chug. Someone grabs his legs and
You're the real chug-blood.
Dumbledore's like, Harry, you're not helping me at all by yelling chug.
Chug-blood, is that what you said?
Is that Scabbers?
Hey! Hey, I have a question
Scabbers
for
Scrotus?
You. Mm-hmm. I'm going to nerd out on this a little bit. Shouldn't he be saying the name of the spell every time he casts it?
Yes! That's also this weird,
crap.
Inconsistent thing.
That's just like you get the hang. Like you understand, you can kind of channel yourself. Like that's how you do it at like the novice level.
But
then after a certain
bastard.
Point, you kind of
are you
figure it out.
Like the biggest Harry Potter apologist
I'm
in the world?
No, I'm just trying to defend Harry Potter for no particular. I'm currently reading Harry Potter again. My daughter, so I'm like totally in Harry Potter mode.
Does she like it?
Out loud? Do you do the voices?
Oh, I just read to her until she falls asleep. I don't think she's really paying
attention.
Yeah,
let's hear your Harry
it's mostly
voice.
For me, I don't do voices. I hate to disappoint
is
you.
Is that really? Snape? Not even Alan Rickman? There he is.
Was that Snape?
I bet it's supposed to be Snape.
It probably was Snape, yeah.
Snape's pretty cool. I like him.
It's Alan Rickman.
Who's this guy? A Three Musketeer? Who is
this
guy?
That's nearly headless Nick.
Really?
I believe so, yeah, because his head was falling off earlier.
But wait, he was played by...
John Cleese.
John Cleese.
That looks nothing like John Cleese.
Well it's based off the books.
But no, it's not. We already confirmed that.
Oh, wait, we did?
Yeah.
That
so this is based off the movies.
Yes.
Well, like I said, they're so close. I guess this is more closer to the art style of the covers of the books than the film. I guess, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Wait, Reiner, did we see something that linked it to the movies?
Yeah, there was a character who looked like an actress.
McGonagall kind of looks like the actress who plays her.
That happens even in these things sometimes.
But I mean, it was totally her. Like, it wasn't like Harry looks like any kid with glasses. It was like, it totally looked like that actress.
That's the Hunger Games.
Okay,
logo.
Guys, it I really gotta figure this out here.
I think you can push that block.
Yeah, but.
Man, we're just
I did that before with X button.
Nice.
Really heated
and
about
it. And I got all.
Potter.
Well, yeah, I got really heated about nearly headless Nick looking like a pilgrim or something. But what?
Pilgrim?
Let's see. All right, so can you just walk into it? Is it that? And you
no,
can't when you
he's
press buttons.
A little boy.
Okay.
I'm a boy.
Yeah, but he's like, you know, he's the chosen one, man.
There's okay, so
boy,
there's Harry. A flashing thing on there, though.
Yeah.
What
other spells do you have? Do you have like a wheel of spells?
You'd have Patronus?
Nope. I got nothing.
That's later, man. Come on. That's the end of Azkaban.
Oh, I wonder if
that's
I charge
a hard
it.
Spell.
There. That will do
that
it.
That looks cool.
That does look kind of
well
cool.
Done.
This right here, Tim, that imagery is why you should watch the movies. Just this one thing.
That's cool. I mean, I like it. It looks like they're trying to fling a you know, fastball.
There he's saying it.
There he's saying it.
Flipendo.
Flipendo?
Yeah. That's the spell.
Kyle, pop quiz.
All right.
How many spells could you name off the top of your head?
Oh, okay. Let's see. Oh, man.
I'm not asking you to list them. Give me a number.
Maybe like three.
Holy. Okay.
I think.
That's a lot.
Yeah, but even now I'm kind of questioning myself.
What's the difference between Hogwarts and Gryffindor?
Gryffindor is
a house within Hogwarts. Like the kids all like are part of different houses.
So the houses are Slytherin, Hogwarts, or Slytherin, Gryffindor,
Ravenclaw,
and Hufflepuff.
Which is also, I got a problem with that because everyone's like, oh, the big choice about like where you want it, what house do you belong to? There's 1,000 Facebook quizzes popping up my feed every day. It's like, okay, Gryffindor, it's the good, boring one. Slytherin, it's the purely evil one. Hufflepuff, it's the wimp one that no one wants to belong to. And then Ravenclaw is like a cool, artsy one.
Well, they're
like,
Ravenclaw's like the academics, I think.
What's dorky about Hufflepuff?
It's basically like the Jigglypuff. It's like where all the...
the Jigglypuff.
It's the Jigglypuff of the Harry Potter world.
But how does that come across?
All the wusses go there that are big softies that can't get anywhere else.
Yeah. So like, what kind of spells are
the
they?
The art students.
What kind of spells are they?
I thought Ravenclaw was art.
No, I don't think. I think Ravenclaw's more academic. They all do the same spells, Tim. They all learn the same thing. It's just it's just basically like their team that they're on while they're there. It's where they live. They live in the Gryffindor section of the castle.
But there might be small differences, like the Slytherin people. They can some in there can talk to snakes, right?
No,
Harry
thing.
Can, but
that's a rare thing to be able to talk to snakes. Yeah. You got to be a Parseltongue for that.
Yeah.
A what?
A Parseltongue.
But the founder of Slytherin.
God, I sound
Can
cool
Can we just
on
talk
episode.
About Star Wars?
It's so much better. It's so much more consistent.
This there. Hedwig.
Oh, is it, Reiner?
Mm-hmm.
Is it really?
That's Harry's owl.
I really, it's funny that you mentioned, because I was thinking about this the other day. You guys are probably going to pounce on me for this. But I was thinking about, like, my favorite fictional, like, broad worlds.
I love it, yeah.
And, like, I would really, personally, like, for me, I would rank Harry Potter.
But for, like, wait, talking about from yourself, from your perspective?
From my perspective.
From you.
The way that this, the things that go on up here.
From
my
dumb glasses
Kyle Hilliard.
I'm just saying, in terms of, like, fictional, like, well-realized worlds, I would rank Harry Potter very high. Like, I would put it up there with Star Wars.
Number two?
Look at the detail
maybe
that
even,
hand.
Maybe even one.
It's just beautiful,
maybe.
Isn't it?
To really think about it.
Look at that hand.
I think it's a pork chop from Minecraft.
Now, does he upgrade to Super Flipendo at some point?
I believe that
Flipendo
is
Flipendo 64.
Yeah.
The Flipendo GameCube.
And there's Virtual Flipendo, which is really just a waste of time.
So my big problem with the Harry Potter universe, Reiner, or Kyle, and the reason why...
Well, you can address me, too.
I will look at you.
I will gaze in your direction.
And the reason why I can't get into it like I can with Star Wars... like. I can't put myself in that universe. Like, the whole thing is like, even if I read this as a kid, I don't think I'd be like, oh, I want to be a wizard. Like, I just can't get into it because I don't know what they're feeling when they're using these spells. It feels so inconsistent as far as like what it takes to actually do the magic. And there's a lot of like Dragon Ball Z style blast back and forth where it's like, what are they channeling? What are they thinking?
Have you read the books?
No.
How's that different from the Force to you?
The Force, because I think the way Yoda describes the Force in Empire, like, it lays it out very clearly, very spiritually. It's like, okay, I understand what he's talking about on a religious level.
Oh, you got your Nimbus 2000.
Whereas this, it's just, hey, you're not saying that word right. Say the word right now.
Okay.
You know?
Hey, make it blurry and special.
Nimbus 2000? Is that what it's called?
Yeah. It's the broomstick.
Mm-hmm. That's a stupid name.
I don't know if he has the Nimbus yet.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. The game kind of goes out of sync with the book.
Hey, hold on, dude.
No, what Ron, don't saying? Go.
But anyway, Hanson, in the books, they do a really good job of describing what it's like to cast spells.
I would,
and, like, very
really
scar skirt, like,
and
hurting when he does certain things.
And one thing I like about, like, the sort of the idea of magic in this world is how just embedded it is. Like, it is just, like, part of... I think they do a good job of, like, representing it as part of everyday life. Like, there's this whole sequence of him describing him just going to the Weasley's house for the first time, where he just sees the way they clean and the way they cook.
Bippity-bobbity-boo.
It's the thing about, like, really good fiction writing is, like, you make the spectacular mundane.
Yeah, like, it's just, like, magic is just this thing that everyone... And they do a really good job with that in some of the films, too.
But I would disagree on that front. It has the Mission Impossible effect, where, like, there's a spell to change people into other people, kind of like the mass of Mission Impossible.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone's just, like... No one sees that coming. Every time they use it, it's just an amazing trick. But wouldn't everybody use that all the time and everyone just
like
constantly
Job's
mess with
magic
each other?
Tricks, just constantly just trying.
What is it? Polyjuice potion. It's very difficult to make, so it's not something that you can just buy at a store or like, you know. And you have to take
Superman
elements
64.
From the people that you're trying to recreate in order to change into them. So like you have to steal. You know, you can't just be, I want to look like Hanson. I have to plan to, like, steal a piece of your hair or something and mix it in that juice.
It's not easy to look like that. Reiner, you're doing a really good job, by the way.
Thank
sorry,
you.
Reiner. We're like, I'm so sorry. I'm just very excited to talk about Harry Potter.
Look at that face.
Madam Hooch.
Madam Hooch?
I don't believe you could say that, dude.
Hooch.
Well, no, it's just slang for booze. And booze is slang for alcohol.
So, Tim, are you going to go watch Harry Potter now?
Are you ever going to do it?
Yeah, I will. I mean, but the problem is, I had finally given up on the idea that the reason I held off so long, just to lay it all out there, is in high school I started getting into Lord of the Rings, and I fell hard for that, and I did the dumb thing when you're too young to realize that this is a stupid thing to do. Mm-hmm. Star Wars versus Star Trek, blah, blah, blah. I did Harry Potter versus Lord of the Rings.
Right.
And then I decided I'll read the books first. Mm-hmm. I've finally gotten over that. I'm like, I'd rather just experience it than never experience it and wait for the books. But now Kyle's explaining all these things makes me think that I should read the books
I
now.
I think it's the way to go. You won't get
I really do love the books. Like,
you'll understand like the high level stuff watching the movies, but I don't understand why people love this world so much from just watching the movies. And there's 1,000 logical questions I have about the universe that aren't explained in the movies.
I don't want to really read these books.
Yeah,
I'd rather
should.
Read a bunch of Stephen King or something. Yeah.
No, but they're breezy. Go for like the audiobooks. I hear they have good narration and stuff. Yeah, that's the way to go.
Maybe that'd be the thing. On the commute or something.
Oh my god. More.
You need that jelly bean, right?
Well, you can collect that later, I guess, after this.
Turn. Oh, Turner and Hooch.
Is that
Turner and Hooch?
Harry Potter's famous catchphrase.
Madame Turner and Hooch. Is that supposed to be the little Wampeter up there?
Oh my
god,
look how tiny it is.
Oh, the Whomping Willow?
Cute.
No, the
ooh.
Quidditch ball?
Like, oh, no, been? That's a jelly bean up there.
I don't think I'm finishing this one.
Oh,
this
Quidditch, that tickles.
Hey, little bastard, get in that hole.
Oh, there you go.
Little doggy.
There you go, there you go. Hanson, did you have a favorite film?
Feather touch.
I did. Did any of them stand out to you?
I'll wait for Reiner to stop drowning in his own saliva.
Hey, you did it. Good job. The basics of
broomstick control. He's the best Quidditch player ever, Tim. He's basically the chosen one when it comes to Quidditch.
Is that right?
As you can imagine, yeah, because his father was good.
He's the youngest Quidditch player in 100 years at Hogwarts.
Right.
I kind of blacked out on your conversation for a while. Did you describe the rules of Quidditch to Tim?
No one cares.
Quaffles.
It sucks.
Is that what the name of the golden...
Quidditch. I will admit, Quidditch doesn't really make a lot of sense to me.
I thought the entire... misunderstood the rules, because I thought, like, if you caught the golden snitch... I remember that name now. That you automatically win, but it's not. You have to. That's how you end
it
the game.
Ends the game. You get 150 points, so you could conceivably gain more than 150 points. But then the question is, like, if the other team has more than 150 points, then you're not going to want to find the
snitch. It's not a good game.
Yeah, I will agree with you there. I think Quidditch has some real issues. And
my favorite movie, Kyle.
Hey,
I was shocked to see. Well, there we go. This is great for the super replay.
It's right over the Martian Gothic.
There you go. No, they're separate cards, I promise. I'm sure of that.
But I was shocked to see it was the lowest rated one on Rotten Tomatoes, but I really like the fifth movie, Order of the Phoenix.
Yeah,
like,
Does
that one have the dance sequence?
What's the synopsis
it does.
On that one? Okay.
I like it. That's like, it's the one that has the closest to what I want, which is like the entire training. Because for the first four movies, it was me just screaming drunk on wine. Like, it doesn't make any sense. What are they feeling? What are they doing? Like, I want like a Dragon Ball Z style explanation of what
Stop
it's like
comparing
to
Harry
stuff.
Potter to Dragon
it's
Ball
like
Z.
It's my closest.
Oh, wait, that's, I want to watch all the Dragon Ball Zs, actually.
That's a really good idea. Yeah. But anyways, like, Order of the Phoenix, like, I just love the training. It's like where things get a little bit more serious. I know like it's happened a couple times before, but I feel like it really kicks into overdrive. And also, like, I love the dance sequence. I love everybody pairing up. It also has, like, my favorite scene. This is a weird call, but, like, my favorite scene in the entire run of all the movies is when...
they go to prom.
Yeah. And Harry is spending time with that one lady. What's her name?
I can't remember her
name. I don't want to be offensive, but her name sounds not great.
Cho Chang.
Thank you, Wade. And then it's after the terrible thing happens to her boyfriend. And they're just like having a fun, flirty time. And then like Hermione and Ron and Harry are hanging out afterwards. And Hermione just like lectures Harry on that front. Like, hey, I know you think you're having a good time. Like, her boyfriend just died? Like, you have no idea what she's going through right now, and this is all fun and games for you, but, like, you have no concept.
Yeah, someone drew a thing. Oh, no, it's a dragon or something.
But wait, Harry didn't know that.
Well, he did, but, like, it's just, like, you forget about it because it's like, oh, it's all flirty and prom, and Hermione's just kind of resetting things. Like, I love any movie that resets things. Like, it reminds me of, like, in The Incredibles when they're in the cave and Elastigirl's talking to the kid. And
sure.
Like, these bad guys are going to murder you. Like, this is more serious than you realize.
Reestablish the tone or acknowledge the tone, the stakes.
I love it a lot. This looks great.
Is this like a bully minigame, basically?
Do you guys play Mad Maestro?
Hey, do you guys hear farts every once in a while? Does that mean I'm doing it right?
Look, in the wizarding world, it's all in the mind.
Hey, was this Warwick Davis' his character?
Yeah, I believe so, yeah.
He played two now, right?
Which like is
he
was weird.
He played the goblin at Gringotts, who ends up being very important later in the film, surprisingly. And then this teacher, yeah.
Perfect. Oh my gosh. Do we have to go to school here?
So one of the big things is they learn spells, and it's kind of fun to watch that.
Kumail Nanjiani actually has a really good bit asking why kids at Hogwarts don't learn math and science. Like, they just do magic. Good. They don't worry about math or anything. They don't worry about that magic.
Would you want to learn math when you can, like, levitate crap instead?
No, of course not.
And summon your worst fear out of a cupboard? Who needs algebra when you can summon your worst fear out of a cupboard? Let's do that again.
I forget what that thing is called. Not
good. Quit talking to me. I'm trying to
let him hear the ding. It's ding. Dong, ding. Dong, ding. Dong, ding.
That was good.
Dong.
Get into it, Reiner.
Ding, dong, ding.
Reiner, thank you for keeping this game moving. All Hanson and I just shouted at each other.
Oh, my God, that was tough.
Kyle, is Harry Potter as a universe better than Dragon Ball as a universe?
Yes.
Yeah.
You're out of your mind.
For sure.
Oh, really?
I love Dragon Ball Z, but it is, even the creators admit that it's just absurd. There's, like, dinosaurs running around for no reason.
Yeah, that makes it fun.
Wait.
It's like, oh, if a dinosaur's tail and eat
there's
it.
There's dinosaurs in Dragon Ball Z?
Yes!
It's way better than Harry Potter.
Oh, okay. Yes. This is much more realized. I also like how it fits into the real world. Like, I love hidden, like, every Pixar movie is a hidden world story, and this is a hidden world
story. But this is a confusing hidden world where it's like, hey, you walk through here.
Yeah, if you drink wine through all the films.
No, but like, I don't understand. Like, if Hogwarts is over there, what happens if somebody in the normal world walks over to Hogwarts? Are they going to hit an invisible wall?
Gilderoy Lockhart erases their mind. He's very good at memory erasing.
Wait, so somebody can physically wander into the halls of Hogwarts and be like, what's happening? I was looking for my shack.
That's actually what the original Hotel Transylvania is about.
I mean, what happens on Google Earth?
Exactly.
It's all enchanted. They can hide that stuff.
That's my problem. Is it what happens if they walk over there? What do they see?
There's like the wizarding population is pretty small compared to humans, I think.
What spell?
I'm sorry, Hanson. I just have to answer your question about that.
Hello.
There are enchantments in place where if someone's wandering too close to Hogwarts, they forget what they're doing and they like go wander away.
Cool.
That's what they say in the book.
They go wander away.
They just like lose interest in where they're going. State.
Yeah, just they get this enchantment that makes them forget what they were doing, and they, you know, it's like a Men in Black situation.
Okay. I'm going to go out on a limb, Kyle, and say your favorite movie is the third one.
It yeah,
seems to be the smart money.
Is it the Prison of Azkaban?
Prisoner of Azkaban,
Is it like the most action-packed one?
It's directed by the guy that did Gravity, whose name I can't remember, Alfonso Cuarón. It does have, like, the time travel stuff, which kind of throws a big wrench in the whole Harry Potter world.
But
time travel, that's, like, the one thing I'm hoping that never happens with Star Wars. It's just, like, keep it out of that. We don't need that.
No, yeah, keep it in Star Trek.
But I will say, I do love that film, but the reason I love it, Cuarón's an amazing director. I think that's the prettiest Harry Potter film, probably. But I really love Sirius Black. He's, like, my favorite character, and I feel like that film highlights him a lot. So.
You say you don't like the time travel. That was the most fun of that.
I mean, but I like it, but it does, like, because the question is, like, why doesn't she just always time travel in every situation?
There's a lot of questions kind of about the Harry Potter universe. But I like the Back to the Future 2 aspect. Like, it's really fun. Like, they see the events from earlier in the film.
And it does have a lot of those Cuarón, like, long shots of, like, flying through Hogwarts and stuff to rewind.
I heard that all those weirdo shrunken heads in that movie weren't in the book, so that just means Alfonso Cuarón is just a huge fan of weird shrunken heads.
Magic.
That wouldn't surprise me.
Look at isn't floating. That, isn't that just wonderful?
It's magic.
It's unnecessary, but it's very magical.
So right now we're getting a semblance of an open world here. I can now explore the castle. They want me to go meet... Ooh, can I levitate that? They want me to meet Hagrid at his hut, so we got
to
find...
Hagrid the hut.
He is a big guy.
I know Hagrid. I know that actor.
Okay, so he says...
Yeah.
What is he...
Oh!
It's not working.
I remember him from Alone in the Dark. Are You Afraid of the Dark?
Where did I put that little guy?
Oh, is he in that? Robert Coltrane, I think, right? Robin.
Oh, Coldplay?
I could be way off about that.
Woo! I'm gonna...
Ric Flair, everyone.
Coltrane.
I mean, I can't get it around this corner.
Where do you need to get
all that juice?
Well, I don't know.
Aren't you? Well, so we're just trying to go outside and meet Hagrid.
I know, but right? That looked like a secret. I could go and... Do you want to see how beautiful Gryffindor common room
looks? Can we go look at the common room?
Oh, God. Polygon.
So the classes learn their own passwords to get in there, and she lets them in.
Got it.
They have conversations with the paintings. They're kind of alive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it's a fun idea. Like every year,
yeah, it is. All right, so next conversation.
Chocolate frogs everywhere.
There's this threat building, but it's always that tension of like, do we still have class? I guess we will, but the class. It's fun because like they're going to class every year for 7 years, and it's slowly like this war is building. And just, I love that tension of like, how normal can we keep it? Should we just cancel this whole thing? Is everything off? Is everything corrupt? Is everything gone? So there are fun elements.
That's cool.
Look, I'm not bashing the entire world. It's a tough thing to get into as an adult just watching the movies.
Sure, I could see that.
Yeah, it reminds me of like when I was making my run through with like Transformers G1 stuff. It was just kind of like... The people that talk breathlessly about how cool Transformers are, like they sometimes nod to like how ludicrous and ridiculous the old cartoons are, but not enough.
Yeah,
you know, as someone who's an adult.
And I will say, like, I read these books in real time. Like,
me too.
I remember like waiting, going.
You mean as they were coming out?
Yeah. Yep. Like, no, I mean like I was waiting for the third book to come out. You know what I mean? So I read them like years apart. You know.
I went to a midnight release for one of the books at a Barnes & Noble, and they put us into the classes, into the dorms.
For lines?
Yep.
That's clever.
To go to the different areas. Yellow. What is the equivalent of yellow?
Wigglytuff?
Yeah, that was in Jigglypuff. Okay, so you gotta find the front door. And that's probably up here.
Well, yeah, that's where you started. That's where those house cups were.
So we go this way?
Reiner, you're doing great, by the way. I just wanted to invite you to maybe play the next episode of Martian Gothic as well.
I have never seen you so out of your depth on a replay, Tim. You are just like glossing over as Hanson talks about Harry Potter history.
But it's fascinating. After I realized it was set in the 90s in our world.
You just broke?
I don't know. Just like, okay, well, I don't know.
What
anything.
Were you thinking it was? It was just straight up
just
fantasy?
Just a standalone.
Well, Lord of the Rings, just like different.
Gotcha.
Different zone. Realm.
They have like flying cars and stuff.
Huh.
Driving
around. Well, the 90s.
He says that spell every time.
But yeah.
Now you got 8 Gryffindor points.
Those points.
We get a cutscene too.
Those points really fall by the wayside as the story goes on. It's like the most important thing in the first book, and then by like the last book.
Well, the teacher makes up a bunch of crap at the end. Like, I'm docking you 15 points for farting in potions class, and then you're getting 15 points for flying around cool like
in
the courtyard.
Stupid as hell to put like a numerical value for like, but you secretly saved the day plus 73 points.
Gryffindor wins.
Our school not being annihilated.
Fight. Oh, you fight Malfoy? Oh, look at Malfoy's face.
That is the worst face.
Wizard duel right here.
How it's do like I
going
shoot?
Down.
How do I shoot, gentlemen?
So this is the Gary to his Ash.
Oh, I bet I got to take his 100%. Things.
Malfoy is awful.
You remember in Rise of the Planet of the Apes, the guy who really overacted the bejesus out of it and was like, it's a madhouse.
Yeah.
It's a madhouse.
That's Draco.
Yeah. Okay, got it. He abuses
animals. I think
fireworks at each other.
This is going to happen way too long.
Oh, there we go.
What do you think of Dolores Umbridge? What do you think of that character?
Don't know who that is, Kyle.
She's the lady.
The pink?
The pink.
Oh, I like her a lot.
She is one of the most effective villains. I hate her so much.
Yeah, just uptight teacher.
Yeah.
Character model.
Whoa. Is that Neville?
Is he the ugly kid? Is that just kind of his role? Is he's ugly?
But then he kind of grows up to be handsome.
Oh,
you know?
That's the kid who actually got kicked out of the films for getting arrested for DUI, I think.
Yeah, that was also really jarring. Like, who is this other guy that's like suddenly the sidekick flying around at the
end? Your head is particularly cocked. There was a somewhat important like secondary character who just got recast like during the last two films because he was like, he got DUI or something.
The guy who played Dumbledore actually died, the main actor.
The first Dumbledore. Yeah.
The messed up part is that Alan Rickman murdered him.
Wow.
I really thought it was uncalled for.
I mean, we'll never solve that now.
Yeah, and that's where J.K. Rowling got the idea.
J.K.
Yeah, she's like, but just J.K. You're supposed to protect me.
Goyle, get in here. So these are his cronies.
Yeah, Crabbe and Goyle.
He's a little too...
Dear God. It's like a Final Fantasy last boss here. Three levels.
I want to like Malfoy. Like, he's always fun, but the idea of taking that character seriously... You know, like, in most movies when they have a bully come on screen and he's just way too over the top and just completely takes you out of it? That's Malfoy. But he is fun to watch, but every time he's on the screen, it's like, well, it's shattered any semblance of a real world. I know it's silly because it's a wizarding world.
It's too cartoonish.
It's absurd.
Yeah, it is.
I do love his sort of wrap-up at the end, though, where he's not really sure where he sort of lands.
I think the dynamic with his dad, I think, is really interesting. Yeah. And I guess
he's an abusive dad or something?
His dad's like, he's like fun evil, but his dad's like seriously murder people evil.
Yeah. Seriously evil black.
And he starts to question, like, subtly, kind of like, do I want to be part of that? Like, do I want to be part of my family anymore? You know?
Yeah, yeah. He looks like a Mickey Rooney in that UI. He's just like an old man pretending to be a boy.
Jimmy Jilliker.
Calls you Potter.
That's right.
What's that?
Come on, Crab and Goyle.
Kyle, here's
Beyonce move there for a second.
Yeah. Oh, I'm out of here.
Why do you think Harry Potter
to Red Lobster
has been so successful with women? Why do women love Harry Potter? I think if I may generalize,
like the character or the book,
just the world,
I guess, worlds. I think it has the highest percentage of female fans.
Well, I mean, does it have a lot of strong female characters?
I mean, the most powerful, like the best wizard is Hermione.
It's beautiful. Isn't that wonderful?
But I think it has a higher ratio than Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, Hermione might be.
Think about it. It's a fantasy series that like was started and gained widespread popularity right out of the gates, and if it's about magic and being in school and targeted towards kids, like at any age you get into it. I don't think that I haven't experienced disproportionately more women liking Harry Potter than guys.
I feel like I have.
It's obviously anecdotal, but like, I don't know. I haven't noticed that. I just think that since they got them young, everyone's kind of into it.
Just rope them all in.
It's a woman writer. I don't know.
Oh, interesting.
So I might have a different sensibility a subtle sensibility that I can't really put my finger on.
Right, right. She seems...
And Hermione's awesome. Like, she's like the smartest wizard in the whole damn...
What I really liked about Hermione, and I assume it's in the books too, but it's so good, is in the first movie, like, she's established as incredibly smart. She, like, knows all the spells. She's a bit of a know-it-all, you know? But then there's that subtle moment where everyone's like learning to fly their brooms for the first time, and she can't get her broom to come to her hand. Like, she's having trouble quietly with like that one little thing.
Yeah, yeah.
I really appreciated that. Oh, hello, horrible Hagrid.
Don't look at his mouth again.
Hagrid's kind of like a big teddy bear, and here he is just sort of like terrifying giant.
It's like a botched clay face. Like, he's just really trying to be human, but he's just melting.
He's like a hut.
Oh my God, do not look Harry in the eyes at all. No, don't do it. Oh, thank God they stopped that rotation. But anyway, Tim, outside of these guys nerding out about this on a very deep level, you should watch the Harry Potter films.
You don't think I should meet him first?
Well, I think the one thing I like about you, Tim, you will, if you really like something, you will stop and go read the source material.
You'll go whole Hogwarts.
Oh. But you go all in, though. Like, you watched all the Transformers. Like,
it's fun. I like to know where the things I like come from, you know? And and yeah, if these books are, obviously they're popular, and Reiner, you speak super highly of them, and... You know,
they're fantastic. I would say you should watch the first film. If you really like that, go back and read everything. Because that first film is
it's a kid's movie. It's more so than the rest of them, I would say.
But it is pretty true to the lore, books well and done, the spirit of it. And they didn't have to cut a lot of stuff out of that one. That one's pretty complete. Her books got huge.
Then maybe I like that idea where it's watching the first book, see if I like it, then read the first. I'm sorry, watch the first movie, then read the first book.
I recommend watching the movie in real time as well.
then go for it.
It's a good idea.
So cold. Your hands are so cold.
I have no.
I usually read books in slow motion, so Harry Potter was different for me.
Do we have to do this, Reiner?
So, but I'm curious what we're learning.
So Reiner Googled, like, why do women like Harry Potter so much? So should we read the Yahoo Answers?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Women are attracted to power. Magic is a type of power. Thank you, Yahoo Answers.
Everyone attracted to power?
No, just women, Tim.
Yeah. You know women.
Is that all we're going to read?
I keep going, I guess.
Got to the bottom of the...
We figured it out. Yahoo did it, you guys.
Yeah. If that's the temperature of the water, you might as well just go like read YouTube comments on our videos. Like, let's just get on that well.
I learned what women want and what women like from YouTube comments, so I guess it works.
See, I thought the whole thing that women liking it was because of the glasses. that Harry wore. So then, remember when Dan Reichert was convinced of that and just decided to wear real glasses?
Yeah,
wait, it was because of Harry Potter.
Just because of Harry Potter, yeah.
Last time Game Informer touched on Harry Potter stuff, it was Jim Reilly and Dan Reichert doing the Wonder Book video, which is still my favorite test chambers ever because it's bizarre.
I feel like we should do more. Is it a weird thing? When I first started at Game Informer, that was something that surprised me, is there really isn't a lot of like sort of fandom for Harry Potter in the office.
Reiner.
Like, well, me. But even still, I don't know. It's quiet, you know? Like, there's big Star Wars fans, well, yeah, big Transformers fans.
New,
you know?
Spell.
I bet secretly Miller could beat you in Harry Potter trivia.
Probably, yeah.
He just will never talk about it. He's a humble man.
Is this fun, Reiner?
No. This is not a good game. It's better than Martian Gothic.
Not good.
I think this is...
Who is this?
You have no hope.
She teaches...
God damn it.
She hangs out in the greenhouse, I think.
Focus, Harry!
With the baby plants. You know what I'm talking about, Hanson?
Yeah, the weird screaming things that are sentient, and then they murder all of them?
Yeah, that if they get a little older, they will kill you, but they still let the students sort of take care of them.
What are they called? It's a classic fantasy thing.
Man,
Tim, what's like the talking root thing called in fantasy tropes?
God, what's it?
The,
Yeah.
You're there. You're
Mandrake?
So close. Mandrake! There we go. You've
mastered the incendio spell.
Oh. You can set things on fire now.
Start those plums on fire.
Out. Did you guys see J.K. Rowling when she tweeted about how much she likes Minecraft?
Oh, really?
Seriously?
She's pretty cool in my book.
Oh, man. So many drunken frogs.
She's a fun
Twitter. Let's see what this spell does and we'll call it a day.
That sounds good.
Okay.
That, if you look at that the wrong way, it doesn't look good, guys.
What?
It's like a plant.
Like a testicles? Is that what you're
talking about? Yeah, exactly.
That's testicles. A big part of the wizarding
plum world testicles.
Of Harry
Potter.
Got it.
Mm. Plum testicles.
Phallic imagery.
Plum testiculius.
What is this?
Oh, boy.
Plum testiculius.
What?
Well, Tim, how many Harry Potter spells can you name off the top of your head?
Infernium Ridiculum.
That's actually, I think,
pretty close.
Ridiculous, I think, is one, actually.
I said I didn't know what it was like and what it felt like to cast a spell, but that UI told me exactly what it feels like. So now
I'm
totally
feeling
understand.
It.
Martian Gothico Unificasha.
I think Unificasha, that's probably something pretty close there.
Ah!
Kyle, what's this news about a new book coming out?
There's a play coming out that takes place like 19 years in the future, and they're releasing the play as a book that you
can. Is it going to be like formatted like the old Harry Potter books?
No, I mean, it's a play, but it's in, like, Rowling wrote it or co-wrote
it. Oh, it's canon.
Yeah, it's canon. It, like, they're much older, and they have their kids and stuff like that.
I can't wait for, like, 50 years from now when they reboot the Harry Potter films, and then we can say that she's Rowling in her grave over what they've done to that franchise.
Do you have that written down?
Hey,
can you, like,
pre-tweet testicle plum
that?
Get... No!
Oh, by the way.
I did it, guys.
Good job. Reiner, thank you so much for staying strong on Harry Potter while I just, like, nerded out.
You guys went nuts. Holy crap.
You did a good job, Reiner.
We'll take a short break.
Replay a kiss. Continuous.
We'll take a short break and we'll be back with some You're in the Movies.
All right, everybody, we're back. We're looking at You're in the Movies again, which is our favorite game, all of us, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we kicked out Ben Hansen because he had surgery recently, and we don't want to kill him by making him do a bunch of wild gesticulations and stuff, so.
So, dude.
And one thing to point out is we entered a cheat code. There's like 50 trailers we can do.
Yeah.
That's
we're
true.
Not gonna show you.
All right, I'm going.
Yeah, go. We're not going to show you what the trailer is. We talked about it last time. It's going to be a secret all the way up to the end here.
Mm-hmm. We don't even really know. Well, we know. Punch out. Okay, so it starts out with Glass Joe. So you remember, he's easy. Frenchman.
You can do it. Yeah, always stretch before you start doing this kind of stuff.
Hit the pad, man.
He says, measure those muscles.
It's like an overhand punch.
Do that.
Oh, get you. Oh, wow. Hey, pretty good, I guess.
How'd you do that?
You don't know your own strength, kid.
Yeah!
What? It's like, you know, when you have a dream and either your punches do nothing or you accidentally murder someone?
Mm-hmm.
And it's never in between.
Whoa!
I've never murdered someone in my dream.
They die in real life, so be careful. Jesus.
Whoa, you broke it. The side punch worked.
Okay. Nice work.
It's a living.
Good enough.
It's a living.
I did it, you guys.
And there's our special guest star, just a shadow in the middle.
Hey. Punch bag.
That's great.
All right, you guys, get up there. Right,
you can do it.
There is, I guess, there's a little hint at least of the names, but don't read too much into those.
Don't read them at all.
Just forget how to read.
You're a little man.
All right, let's see. I guess these are all new mini games because I didn't punch anything last time, right?
Are these mini games or are they micro games?
These are. That's a good miniature games. Oh, okay. Tim's having a good time. Reiner doesn't understand how drums work, as near as I can tell. But he looks like he's winning, though.
Look at that monkey go! The guy says.
How did Reiner win that? Tim was way more enthusiastic.
Are they measuring enthusiasm? Is that what the technology does?
I think so. I mean, this game was way ahead of its time.
Well, watch this. Jeff Cork.
Go zombie. Oh, we gotta play the roles of our characters.
I guess that's true.
I was way too energetic for a zombie.
Maybe. Kind of, though, right? Like, I guess that reveals something about what we're doing here.
I love how excited Cork is.
What kind of zombie is this?
Oh, this is a yellow shirt zombie. There's probably a game with a yellow shirt zombie. You all right there, Cork? Okay.
Okay. You're in feudal Japan. Actually, this is just Mortal Kombat. Test your might.
Hey, eat the sushi.
Oh, can you eat the sushi?
There you go. That'll come through really well in the final version, I'm sure. Nice. Oh, no, Jeff, that one got away.
Oh, there we go. There's the pat. There's the Cork shrug. That was a highlight of the last trailer we put together.
Meow.
I guess we should point out that we actually went through the trouble of setting up a green screen. There is no way we could make this like any better, and we're still like struggling with like little bits of green screen are coming out.
Maybe it's because of our own shadows against the green screen. That's probably our problem.
We're really close to the green screen.
Yeah. This isn't what's the name of Peter Jackson's thing?
Weta.
Lord of the Rings. Oh.
And I also brought a green shadow today. Which,
get over there.
In retrospect, not a great idea.
All right. So our hero, Kyle Hilliard.
Kyle's
a hero.
A hero.
Yeah.
Hero to all.
I want to see your hero come through here, Kyle.
Yeah.
There we go.
Pretty good.
Stoic.
Oh, good.
Get in the outline. Step one, hero. Back. Oh, yeah.
Wave at the camera.
Are you...
He said, don't stop.
Hey. First, it was late, and then he moved out of frame.
It's going to be him rubbing his nose.
What a hero.
He's really the hero we deserve.
Oh, no.
Oh.
That's not heroic.
I think it's heroic waving. Well, you see the spider. Come on. You know, I don't even know if the games are necessary. This would be fine. Just do all these.
Look down in the well. Oh.
Watch out, it's the ring lady. It's the little grudgeling.
What was that face?
That's just a fish. How'd that get in there?
You look like Church Lady, Saturday Night Live.
That's true.
I think he said it best when he said, what a moment.
What a moment. That moment certainly existed.
So, dude.
I think I won, you guys.
So.
Yeah. That went quick.
We do have to press a button.
All right, hero.
There goes red hero. Yeah.
Two heroes, so it's like Batman and Robin, maybe?
Look, we're not paying attention to the roles. Catch the golden film reels to dodge the junk.
That a boy. Put a cape on him.
Oh, yeah, he's better at this. Catch the golden film reels and dodge the junk. All right, so you got to catch the golden film reels, Tim, and dodge the junk.
No, you said that wrong.
Dodge the junk.
Dodge the junk.
Wait, is that... Okay. Oh, yeah, you don't want that.
Get it!
There you go. Catch more reels to keep scoring. It does take stuff from these games, right? It's not just those sequences where we had to act, right?
Seamlessly.
Okay.
Look out!
Oh, man, Tim's good at this game.
This is going to be a very understated performance.
Never mind. Come on, man.
Understated.
Oh, no!
Dodge that, you moron!
Come on, what are you doing?
You turned pink.
You don't want that coffee.
Hero!
You have 4,000 points. Get that. Oh, there you go. Oh! That was pretty good. I was nervous for you.
That was pretty good.
You just got a pretty good on that one, too.
Yeah. Stock footage and
body double. I'll take it pretty good.
About time.
All right, here you go. Come to the set,
please. Remember, this always lasts a little longer.
Oh, these think? Monkeys.
No, it lasts just long enough. Maybe even not long enough. Oh, he's got a plan here for a special.
Wait,
entrance.
Where's Reiner? Get on set.
Wow. Dude, that was amazing. The more you shake, the more you score. All right, there you go.
Is that it? Just shake.
Well, what more do you want?
And action. Oh, Maraca's gravel.
Oh, there you go. All right. It's like so, that Dreamcast game.
Oh, you got to find where they are on the screen.
There you go.
Oh, look at that monkey. It's Samba de Amigo.
Hey, come on. Keep it safe for work here.
Whoa.
Yeah. Okay, pretty good.
I was going to say, I love how that move garnered him no additional points whatsoever. It really is Samba de Amigo.
That's true. It was almost as helpful as Obi-Wan's twirl.
This was originally like a milking the cow minigame.
That's true.
It's a bit much.
Yeah, we don't know about that.
And also, cows don't stand up on their hind legs.
Just really tall cows walking in.
Well done. Amazing. Pretty good.
These zombies seem pretty cool.
Yeah, this is going to be a great flick. Fire,
get your butt on the set. Oh, get your butt on the set, on the set. Get your tuckus out there.
There he is. He got his butt on the set. And strike the targets. You got it? You got it, Jeff? You ready? You're in a dojo. Pretend you're in a dojo, they say.
Oh, yeah. Really work outside your normal routine here in this game. It's face to the side.
Development.
Yeah, like this.
Oh, that's different.
Man, they always feed him.
Oh, there you go.
Yikes.
Yeah,
he has a great acting contract.
Ouch. Ooh, ouch, ouch.
Look out for that thing.
Jump.
Oh, gosh.
Cork.
Oh, no, you stood up too soon.
Cork, you're in the movies. Be careful.
There you go. That's the professional actor I know. You're like the Sam Jackson of this replay show.
Oh, good move. Oh, he almost fell. Like, legitimately fell.
Oh, no, he's
bored.
He can see the Matrix. What are you doing? Ouch. I can feel that.
Oh, don't touch those, Jeff.
I think your little green shadow outline got hit, so that counted.
Oh!
He had that. You only got 8,000 points for that one.
Pretty good.
That was fun.
It's fun to watch.
Fun for us to watch, yeah.
This is the best game.
Kyle.
It's really fun to play, guys.
I know how headphones work.
You gotta shake your hips to spin the hula, dude.
How'd these camera things fail?
People don't talk about it, but Kyle is a pro hula hooper before he started writing about video games. Big hips.
Big guy on the North Carolina hooping circuit.
Oh my gosh, the biggest.
North Carolina, he says.
Hey! Well, he's so big that he spanned both Carolinas. Okay, so
that's not how you do it, dude. There you go. Yeah. Just
this is like Superman 64. There's going to be more rings that you're going to go through.
Hey, do it with your neck. Can you do that?
Oh, too late. Well, A for effort. An F for flair.
That's A is really polite. I would have been happy with a B.
Oh, it's Tim's turn. Hey, you want to know something weird?
What was that?
Factoid? My wife was a pro unicyclist.
What?
Yeah, she could do all sorts of tricks and stuff on them.
Is that just a unicyclist? Do they just default?
Yeah,
no, she was like in a newspaper for being like a pro.
Is Uniracer like her favorite game of all time?
No.
Oh, because it doesn't have people.
It's unrealistic.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay. All right, face slap, pretend you're walking. That's how Tim walks to the office every day.
Is he puffing up his cheeks?
Oh, God, look at that walk. Perfect. Good. All right, what is this?
I don't know if it's going to read well on camera, though. You need
face
to really...
Right. Okay, you're pushing something.
Pretend it's a silent film. You really need to emphasize.
Oh, your face is facing into the background.
Buster Keaton right here.
Busted Keaton.
Busted Keaton. Charlie.
Those photos
Charlie
look
complain.
Good. Hey, hero.
Oh, good.
Oh, I got to go.
It's an HD camera.
Big camera hog here.
Kyle, what is that face?
Oh, that's my normal face.
They use these cameras on Star Wars.
Star Wars. No scoring. Just follow my instructions. Yeah, just do what feels like right. Can you guys tell me what they're saying? Act like a star.
Act like a star. It's just new, like, pickup stuff. Surprised. It's just... Act surprised.
It's...
Wait, yeah, right now.
Oh,
keep,
you're
keep
happy
going.
Surprised. You don't need to talk.
Not Larry David surprised.
Yeah, pantomime.
Have you ever expressed surprise before? Is that...
I'm pregnant.
Yep.
Other way. Yeah, yeah. Now, you can look to the left. Look. Yeah, yeah. Walk.
Walk.
That's a run.
No, that's...
Yeah, now you're marching.
An amble.
Oh, okay. Now you're playing quap.
You brought the house down. Beautiful.
They said you brought the house down.
Oh, good. Okay.
What are we... Which, okay, round two. Two more.
I won again.
Here we go. Right. Who won? Kyle? No.
Oh, my God.
Reiner.
You suck, dude.
Hey!
Uh-oh. Zombie time.
Zombie.
Dad Rising.
You a Cranberries fan, Tim?
I like that song growing up.
Because it has the word zombies in it?
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Hey,
wait, you guys are just assuming that you're supposed to be playing piano?
Hey, back to back.
Back to back. But like sexy.
No, no, move. You're not quite in frame there.
Come on, scoot
not quite
get,
in frame.
There you go.
Okay.
What is Cork doing?
You're not quite in frame. Oh. You see the dividing line, Reiner?
There you go.
Yeah.
All right. Cork is, Cork's making it sexy.
Well, that's Cork.
That is, yeah. Jeff, sexy Cork.
Oh, ouch! Play the tambo!
Is that what that's called, the tambo?
Yeah, that's right. Oh, and the wind chim.
That's a gong.
The gonk.
The wind chim?
Oh, there, Merrick. Darth Merrick.
Oh, God, Cork is pissed at those maracas.
Ooh, batting it like a little kitten. Meow. Play the original cymbal.
No. You don't play cymbals like a piano, Jeff Cork.
Honk. Ah, the bazooka. Classic.
Reiner's use. Draw!
That was an antique Model T horn that you were squeezing.
I think you guys broke the game because you get 9999 and there are no other space for additional characters. So I think
get up there,
the
hero, and shut up.
Oh, God. We killed it.
Jeff Punch and I the coordinated targets. Before recording, and yep. We're around the same page here.
Yeah, it shows. You guys are in sync.
It's time for some training. Punch the targets until they disappear.
Punch the targets until they disappear.
Targets.
The more you beat, the more you score.
The target, you won't score any points.
Beat the target.
What a play.
And I think it's suggesting that you should face the side that you want to punch.
I'm guessing he's going to be punching some zombies here, Jeff.
You no.
No, he's punching priceless art.
What a hero. Oh.
My
so
hero.
Strong.
Thank God you're here, yeah. Kyle Hilliard.
Here, let me fix my sleeve before I punch you.
Yeah. Oh, hold on. It's like an Animal Crossing villager style fighting, just indirect. Pretty good. Oh, yeah, you actually get hero right after you're done.
Nice thumbs
look,
up.
I got the 999 score.
Well done, Kyle.
Kyle, you
Kyle.
Did it.
Sting like a bee.
He's all
I'd like to
these
see you guys get some. I wish I was still logged in as myself. Get all these achievements. Oh, well.
Sweet Chivos.
Oh, is this that you get to do
oh,
hips?
Wow. Oh, wow. Look at this.
Oh, all right. We'll have to
check
do
your
a,
money maker.
We'll have to do a who made it sexier.
Get that hoop moving.
Can you pull up your shirt a little bit?
Yeah. Yeah. Can we see some
what
skin?
What the?
Hey, no.
Whoa.
Okay.
You're too big, man.
Hey, guys, I'm kind of uncomfortable right now. Okay,
can you
now
say goo goo gaga?
Oh, there you go. Oh, yeah. That's cheating. Oh, yeah. I didn't get a chance to do that. No, I'm not giving that any applause. Garbage hula hooping.
Garbage hula hooping.
Garbage hooping.
That doesn't fly in North Carolina.
The
that's
old
sure.
garbage
hoop. South Carolina, Jeff Cork.
Both Carolinas oh, yeah. are equally...
Yes. I don't know. I all wish right. you'd talk about
you
it.
You know what? I'm starting to question it myself, frankly.
Yeah. I'll show you a map sometime.
Movies.
Are oh, you got it, Reiner?
Get my workout for the day.
Oh, okay. Here we go. Zombie time.
Zombie. Act like a zombie.
You're
act
zombie.
Like a zombie. This consumerist culture that we live in. Just act like yourself.
Okay, I don't know about that. You just kind of look like a confused...
What's he doing? Oh,
what? What is your zombie? All right, when you get back on mic,
you're still up. You're still up.
Get in the outline.
I want to hear like what was going through your zombie's
you
dead
dismissed
brain.
Yet. You're walking in the dark.
Okay, you can't see anything. Oh, you're asleep.
Walking
you just
in
woke
the
up. Your daughter just woke you up.
And I was hungry.
They loved you, baby.
What? Why is? What was that move?
Yeah, what was going on there? What were you doing?
I was gonna look at my crotch.
Is that what zombie? Is that a zombie?
They do. That's the first
why
thing they do, and then they eat brains.
So damn much.
I really right, don't Kyle. Know if I can follow your logic. But
no, it didn't make any sense.
That's all right. In the spotlight. There's no story. There he goes.
Just show me your acting talent.
Your acting talent.
All right, run get in the outline. Run as fast as you can in the spot.
Faster.
Look at him and the guy in the example have similar hair.
I think ooh, one of them has run before, though, and the other one has
that's
not.
That's correct. Run on the spot. I love the little swagger that the silhouette has when it turns. You see it?
More feeling.
More feeling, it said.
More feeling into it.
Okay.
Very nice, Kyle. I like the smile.
Yeah, it was a handsome
those pictures.
Handsome mug.
That was me. That was my, like, you know, I'm happy to be running. I'm excited. I'm out of breath. That's pathetic.
I feel like the heroes are getting a lot more attention.
What'd you say?
I said it's glad it's just not me.
Okay, good.
Yeah. Just follow my instructions and show me. Okay, he says undo your zipper.
What? Slowly. Not that one.
What if it just started giving you, like, just take your shirt off.
Just a little bit.
Oh, look cool. You don't even have to do anything.
That a boy.
Oh, man. you just defined the word just now, I think.
Wave your arms and scream like you need help.
Scream like you need help.
What?
Why? Okay, you're drowning, I guess?
But no, you're not drowning because you have that.
Yeah, what's going on?
Makes no sense.
Maybe it's full of lead.
it's just like cement feet, basically. Yep. Oh, man.
All right.
I want a break. I hope I don't have to go right up again. All right, who won that one?
I won.
Oh, no.
Reiner, you're cheating.
Hey,
so
I mean, you got to improv. You got to do different things that your characters normally wouldn't do. That's how you get spotted.
All right, guys. There you go.
Oh, it's us.
It's us.
I hope it tells you guys to kiss.
Scoop mud under your opponent.
Scoop mud. Hey, we've done this before.
It's just like face each other and kiss as much as possible.
Splash your opponent
back to back.
You can't see them anymore.
Wait, you're splashing each other or pulling in a rope?
You've never pulled mud at your friends?
I suppose I have.
Is it over the? Oh, there we go.
Oh yeah, it flips it around.
Oh, Jeff, don't open your mouth like that.
Yeah, close your mouth.
Wow, Tim is just splattering you with all
Tim's
sorts
winning.
Of goodness.
Tim knows how to do this game. Tim is clearly flung mud.
Oh, nice form, Tim.
Are you just giving up, Cork? Is that what's happening?
He's as happy as a pig.
Jeff, you got tons of mud on you.
Oh, I'm sorry, Cork. I feel like you did your best, but it
99999. Jeez,
keep breaking this game.
Zombie.
I need you on set, please.
Reiner's zombie character is weird.
Get the zombie on the set.
He wants to check his pants and he's hungry, but he's not hungry or something.
Checking the pants.
Okay. Oh, we got escape the charging bull. Adding some extra season there.
To escape the charging bull.
Oh.
This announcer sounds as exhausted as I feel after running the place. Oh, that's great.
Okay, I like that a lot, actually.
You're getting away from your pants. There you go.
He sure got a mean look about it.
Oh, no, no,
oh,
no,
no. Oh, ouch, ouch, ouch. Oh. Ouch, away from my chappies. Don't hurt my chappies.
Oh, you did it. Oh, that was close.
Poor bull. I feel bad for the bull.
Oh, he's fine. I mean,
I love that song, Bad to the Bull. It's good.
Yeah, we keep getting 99.
I think I just won with that score.
Pretty good.
Pretty good.
Okay, here we go.
Come on, Kyle. You got it. Shake those cocoa nuts out of the tree.
That was happening?
Oh, okay. Yep. Cocoa nuts. Oh, Kyle, can't wait to see you shake those coconuts.
Out of the tree.
Out of the tree. Coco Loco, kid.
Shake the Racer. Coconuts out of the tree. The more that drop, the more you score.
Oh, the more that drop, the more you score.
Oh, are you strangling a Zambi?
That bull wore me out. Holy crap.
Shake that cocoa tree.
Do it.
Chicka chicka
Shake
boom boom.
Shake your money maker.
Will there be enough room in hell for all these coconuts?
It's raining nuts, boys.
More vigorously. And
hey, you're not holding the tree, man.
Once more with feeling.
Yeah.
Pretend it's Bart Simpson, everyone.
Cut your hair.
Come on.
You're getting there. You have a chance at 9999.
You got 10 more seconds of this. Keep going.
It's it didn't stop you short.
I got them all.
Oh,
attaboy.
Oh yeah, you maxed out.
Ah.
Hey, attaboy, kid. Hey, Kyle, you're a star.
You got the stuff.
I am playing a zombie.
This is it. I think this is it. Well, and then we do pickups, and then
round 4 of 4.
Can't wait. Can't wait.
Really sell this, Jeff.
Time for your starring moment.
I think in one
this
of my
this is your starring moment.
Follow my instructions.
Follow his instructions, okay?
I think in one of my scenes, I'm just going to be checking my cell phone. See how that plays out in the final sequence.
Okay, you're doing what I did. So now check the crotch.
Open mouth.
Zombie's worried that something might be gone.
This is good. That's a good zombie.
I feel like I'm learning a lot about Reiner's zombie character. That was a genuinely good zombie.
Okay, nice work. Now do it the other way.
Do it,
You're trying to find your way in the dark.
You don't...
You're hungry.
Okay, so you're like kind of searching. You're not necessarily a zombie.
You're worried something fell off your body.
You're very sarcastic. No, you're just checking for your keys. I think Reiner is implying something different here.
Nice work.
All right, is this it? Pickups for everybody? Okay.
I mean, that would generally be one of your first thoughts if you still had thoughts.
Do you,
like,
I don't think you have
is
thoughts.
Is it okay?
It's time for your starring moment. There's no scoring. Follow my instruction and act.
Says, do what feels good.
Yeah. Do what feels right. Give me the
scariest. That's supposed to be a scary face.
Step up, yeah.
Step up your game, Timmy.
Scariest face. That's a mean face. No, scary, not scary. Mean. Oh. Scary.
More surprise, less surprise.
Okay, you're Freddy.
We got there.
You're Freddy Krueger. No.
Oh, the scene's over.
What a handsome boy.
That's pretty scary.
Your new profile pic, your dating site. Oh, it's
is
a
wrap.
All right.
Folks.
Come on, let's see our trailer.
So is that it? Are we? That's okay, here we go.
Oh.
Oh, cool. Pre-movie trivia.
Labyrinth.
Mm.
Star Wars Episode 2.
Oh, oh, in and out. I love that.
At porno.
Caveman style.
The Flamingo Kid. Is it Matt?
That's just the name of the movie.
There you go. It,
the answer
is
the Flamingo Kid. Get quiet.
Shh, boy.
Shut my popcorn
fork.
What?
Oh.
Come on.
It was a night like any other at the museum.
Ooh.
Hardly anyone was there.
What?
Wait, are we together?
And no one looked at the orc.
Wait, what is happening? Yeah, that happens. That's some genuine acting right there.
Constantly rubbing his nipples.
Oh, God. Oh, there's the spin.
Zombies.
Oh, gosh, there's a lot.
Oh, no, too many.
What are we doing?
Orc lovers.
Oh, gosh. Oh, that
tips. Oh, he got me.
Oh, yeah, get out of here. I'm very excited about this. Who am I fighting? Oh, there we go.
Oh, no, too many.
No.
Not a pebble.
I just want to kiss you.
Run for your lives.
Oh.
Why did Tim get murdered so quickly? Oh, there he is. Oh, you're a zombie now. Zombies.
Oh, am I?
With opinions about art.
Oh, no.
Get a lot of mileage out of that zombie walk.
Oh, that looks good.
There we go.
So next time you visit an exhibition. Look out.
Oh, my God. What about me?
Oh, you're in there. You're in
Look
there.
Look at all of
I
us.
I turn into a zombie.
Yeah, you turn into a zombie.
You're a little baby who farted, too.
Oh, that was weird.
The baby was great.
That's the 200. Well,
that was great.
Do we want to replay it? No.
No. We had to burn that
Delete.
One.
That is another episode of Replay, everyone. If you want to see more You're in the Movies, we really like making them. Just let us know.
We've got like 30 more movies to do, so.
Yeah. We'll see you in 7 days for another episode. Thanks for watching.